Hello and welcome. My name is Manisha and you're watching Flash On. On 16th of December, India celebrates Vijay Diwas, the day on which during the 1971 India-Pakistan war, the Pakistani forces in the East agreed to a complete and unconditional surrender. It is the day on which the 1971 war ended. But for some, the war is still on. Many soldiers were taken as prisoners of war and never returned. Their families are still waiting for them. Here is the list of the brave soldiers who were taken as prisoners of war and never returned. All the names that you read are of those who fought for the country. They were captured in action and there is ample evidence for the existence of these 54 prisoners in the Pakistani jail. On December 26, 1974, R.S. Suri received a handwritten note dated December 7, 1974 from his son. The letter contained a slip in which his son had written, "I am okay here." The covering note read, "Sahib Walikum Salam, I cannot meet you in person. Your son is alive and he is in Pakistan. I could only bring his slip, which I am sending you now. Now going back to Pakistan." Signed, M. Abdul Hamid. In August 1975, he received another postmark. The letter said, "Dear Daddy, Ashok touches thy feet to get your benediction. I am quite okay here. Please try to contact the Indian Army or the Government of India about us. We are 20 officers here. Don't worry about me. Pay my regards to everybody at home, especially to mummy and grandfather. Indian government can contact Pakistan government for our freedom." The then Defence Secretary had the handwriting confirmed as Ashok's and changed the official statement from killed in action to missing in action. Major A.K. Ghosh's photograph was published in Times magazine dated 27 December 1971. The photograph is a proof that Major A.K. Ghosh was in Pakistani custody when the war ended on 17 December 1971. He did not return with the prisoners of war in 1972 at the time of the Shimla Agreement. He may have died in the interim period in a Pakistani jail. Both the Indian as well as the Pakistani government can work together to find out what happened to these men. Why was his name not included in the prisoner of war's list? Mohanlal Bhaskar, who was in a jail between 1968 to 74 and repatriated on 9th December 1974, wrote a book in Hindi called I Was a Spy for India, and he gave a signed affidavit stating that he met Colonel Asif Shafi of 2nd Punjab Regiment of Pakistan and Major Ayaz Ahmed Sipra in Fort of Attock, imprisoned for conspiring against Zulfikar Bhutto in the infamous Attock conspiracy. The Pakistan Major Ayaz Ahmed Sipra spoke of his befriending a Gill of the Indian Air Force and a Captain Singh of the Indian Army, as well as mentioning that there were around 40 prisoners of wars of the 1965 and 71 wars in that jail who had no chances of release. In a biography of Benazir Bhutto, British historian Victoria Schofield reported that a Pakistani lawyer had been told that Kot Lakhpat prison in Lahore was housing Indian prisoners of war from the 71 war. They could be heard screaming from behind a wall, according to eyewitnesses within the prison. Pakistani media outlets have also alluded to the men's existence. The shooting down of Wing Commander Harisain Gill's MiG-21 on 3rd of December 1971 was followed that day by a radio broadcast in which military spokesperson claimed that an ace Indian pilot had been captured. An American General Chuck Yeager also claimed in his autobiography that during the 71 war, he personally interviewed Indian pilots captured by Pakistan. The airmen were of a particular interest to Americans because at the height of the Cold War, the men had attended training in Russia and were flying Russian-designed and manufactured aircraft. The families also claimed that on two occasions when they were allowed to visit Pakistani jails, jail guards privately attested to the men being alive before being ushered away by the prison authorities. Even after all the evidence, now the question is why Pakistan did not release them. Is it because they knew too much to be released, or Pakistan was just trying to take revenge for the loss? This all might be true, but the biggest reason is that India forgot about them. These men are the forgotten 54 of India. Well, that's all for Flash On today. Please share this video to create awareness about this, because those families are still waiting for the soldiers who never returned from the war. Thank you so much for watching.